Hello everyone, and welcome to my Chillin in the Tub Diaries. Today's tub is going to be filled with Lush. So what I have today is the Space Girl Bath Ballistic. This is what it looks like. It smells really good. Kind of a berry scent. And because Lush is not moisturizing at all, and I'm not going to lie about that, I actually have Strawberry Feels Forever massage bar, which I'm going to stick in there because it's basically just a bunch of butters, and when you buy their butter ball, all it is a ballistic with butter. So I'm going to stick this in there to have some moisture, and I'm going to use my comforter bubble bar. Okay, so that's what we're going to use today. Okay, see you in the tub. Okay, I'm in the tub now. This is it. And it's nice, I could feel the massage bar. It's really nice. It's a real pretty pink color. My massage bar is melted. And in all honesty,
when you buy them butters, basically all they did was put butter in it. So if you have I have like big chunks of mango butter, shea butter, cocoa butter that I buy from Coastal Scents and Nature's Garden. You could actually get a chunk and stick that in your tub. It's the same thing. So, you know, if you do like some Lush products and they smell nice or whatever, but they're not really moisturizing and they're not, then you could simply just put some butter in your tub. So, let me see. So this, you could feel it straight away, the butter in it. The bubbles. They glisten like diamonds. I love the Comforter's bubbles. I think it has the best bubbles out of everything. I just love the bubbles. They're so fluffy and they're soft. They feel like cream. And I think that's the only one from Lush that I've actually tried that. The bubbles actually feel extremely moisturizing and they do feel like cream. So I love them. Smells really nice. So it smells like nice and kind of like a berry bath, I guess. Very nice, very lightly scented. Now, I'm putting the water on my shoulder, and it feels like I'm putting moisturizer on it. My shoulder feels like there's butters on it. This is awesome, guys. Really, really moisturizing. I'm really, really glad I stuck that little piece of strawberry faux rubber in here. Very nice. Very, very nice. It's really moisturizing. It makes a big difference. Very big difference. I'm not feeling good today, so I'm just kind of mellow out. And this is kind of the music I listen to when I'm by myself at home or with Rena. We listen to a lot of Spanish music or Mexican music, whatever you want to call it. And this is Antonio Aguilar. I really, really love him. I love his voice. My mom took me to see him when I was a little girl. Okay, let's see. Tub Talk. I was a little girl. My mom and dad took us to Oakland, I think. And we saw his father, Antonio Aguilar. And he has this beautiful show of horses. And his horses dance. And there's nothing I've ever seen like it anywhere else. He is known for his dancing horses, and they're so beautiful. They're just gorgeous. So my mom and dad took us to go see them, and he was a little kid, and he sang, and I had a crush on him, I remember. My mom and dad used to always take us to concerts and stuff. They're really cool. So I really love that. Music was important to my mom and dad. I remember her mom had a 64 Impala, and it was lowered, and it was white, and it had red leather inside. And they used to take us cruising and stuff and listen to all kinds of oldies. And my parents were really cool. They really were. We you know, from San Jose, California, and we were just raised that way, you know. My dad was an old gangster and my mom was a chola, you know, and that's just how I was raised. So, yeah. I'm not really sure how long to leave these videos because I get a lot of positive feedback that they're very mellow and people like to just chill and watch it, so I don't know. I guess I'll just do it until this song and then I'll take my bath. This is my mom's favorite song. And it's a very sad song. It's about a lady who's alone. She sits there and chills their cigarette, basically. It's sad, but it reminds me of my mom. It's her favorite song. I missed my mom. Let me see what's been new here. Well, I'm gonna try and talk next time because I still want to play this song. Okay. Well, if anyone's on my Facebook, they know about what's going on with my husband and overseas, and just please keep that in prayer because our president made some really crazy decisions, which has our military out in the ocean pretty much in a really crazy predicament. And so I'm just asking anyone to pray for our military right now. And, for all the people of Syria, especially in Damascus, because there's a lot of bad things that have already started getting killed. And it's just heartbreaking to me that, you know, we could trust someone so much and they end up being, they say they're a person who's against war and they end up being a pro-war leader. So I feel really betrayed right now, and I don't know if I should say that, but I do. I feel like I was lied to. I put my trust in someone that, well, I always put my trust in God before man, but I mean, still, you know, it was just kind of messed up. So now we're stuck in the same situation as we were with the last president, basically. And with the two nominees for this president, basically, we just have to choose between two evils. So it doesn't matter who wins because they're exactly the same. So yeah, just, you know, I know a lot of people get caught up in what side to choose, but you know, I choose life, love, and humanity because it doesn't matter where somebody's from. Everybody's the same. Everybody bleeds when you cut them, and every mother cries when her child gets killed for no reason. Every parent loves their children no matter where you're from. So, you know, that's just heartbreaking to me. That's basically what's been on my mind all week. My husband's in the middle of that over there, so we're trying to be cool. I'm trying to be calm and, you know, just not have an opinion on whose side is what, but just to see people as people and nothing more than that, no matter where they live. I honestly feel for everybody involved in this whole mess, and the people of Syria and Iran and everywhere else in the world that have to go through all this war crap. It's always the people who are innocent, you know, and the leaders are the ones who make the decisions for us. And it's innocent people who have to die. My heart goes out to everybody. So I don't care if you're Christian, because I'm a Christian and I believe in Jesus. And, you know, I totally believe that that's the only way to heaven and stuff. But that never, ever, should I say, blinds me to the love I have for people in general. That I love, you know, I don't care what religion you are or who you believe in or what you do. That has nothing to do with me, you know, and it's just kind of, I get sad for people because I see everybody, people being killed because of what religion they are or people being forced into religions, and it's just sad, you know, so my heart goes out to everybody no matter where they're from. That's just, I don't know, that's just who I am. I know probably somebody will say something, but that's just who I am. I don't think we were ever meant to hate or judge each other. That wasn't what we were supposed to do while we're here on this earth. So that's basically been my thing. I was trying to say what I'm doing, but I got a phone call from my husband and I got a message from our person on a ship, and it's been really bad. So yeah, I'm really stressed out, guys. It's praying and hoping everything's gonna be okay. So yeah, I'm gonna finish my bath now. I think I made this video last way too long. I apologize. I just keep getting, you know, like messages where people saying you should make it longer or talk more in the tub. So I'm talking. Sorry about the subject, but that's what's been on my mind. I try to talk about what's going on in my week, and in my week right now has been all about war and deployments and this president and everything. So yeah, you asked, so I'm giving it to you. All right, everyone. I will see you after I'm done with my bath to let you know how it was. God bless you. Bye-bye. Okay, my bath is over. This is what's left. Most of the bubbles are gone. It was such a soothing. I am so moisturized, you guys. When I was laying in the tub, actually laying down, I feel like I have I scrubbed and put massage bar on my body and it's sunken in. That's how awesome and moisturizing this bath is. Oh my gosh. It's absolutely amazing. So sorry I kind of OD'd on the talk. I just needed to vent. And that's what chilling in the tub time is all about. Just kind of saying what I need to say and having a good bath. So far, this is one of my favorite baths. I honestly think you could do this. Actually, it wouldn't matter which bath ballistic or bath bomb you use. It would be from anybody. If you use a comforter bubble bar and some massage bar or butter, it's going to be the perfect bath every single time. So I hope you all have a wonderful time this weekend, should I say? And happy bath time. I'd like to see if anyone else is going to take a bath that you put in yours. Okay, everyone. Bye. Time to hang this up. Until next time. Bye, everyone. God bless.